So today is another screen reader fundamentals video. So I realized that when I was trying to do my screen reader demos, I failed to go over tables. So today we are going to learn about tables. And why these are so important is because they are used to present visual information in a way that is in a column-like format so that people don't have to try to put a whole bunch of words to describe, like, an image, sort of. But they can be a pain in the butt for blind people if we don't know what we're doing. So we're going to learn about that. We're going to learn about how to navigate a table. There are 5 basic keyboard commands that we are going to use. And I will get into them. For this demo, I am using Western Michigan University Waldo Library Hours. The link will be in the description. And also a command reference will be in the description. You can look at the description for the exact table I'm using, but any table should work. So let's get started. All right, I've already pulled up my library hours, so let me Alt+Tab.
Waldo Library, yeah, Waldo.
Here we go. All right, let me Control Home.
Link skip.
Okay, I'm at where I want to be. So the first command we use is we use T. Now, remember from the other video, if you watched it, and if you haven't, please do, the web commands overview video, I'm not sure if I covered T, but T is for tables. And a table, like I said earlier, is something that is used to present information visually, and it's kind of in a column or row format. So we're going to figure out if there's a table on the page by hitting T.
Main landmark table with 8 rows and 2 columns, row 1, column 1, day.
Table with 8 rows and 2 columns. So there, right there. It describes how many rows and how many columns. Okay, great. Awesome. That's cool. So now we know that we're in a table. Now we have some special keyboard commands that are used in tables. So the first one is Ctrl+Alt+down arrow. So let's do that once again here.
Row 2 Mondays.
So, we have Ctrl+Alt+down arrow, which is moving us by the first column, which, if you recall, it said days. I'm not sure if that cleared capture, but it just said days. So, it's the days of the week. Let me quick maximize
system
this.
Menu.
I forgot to
Waldo
do that.
Light.
Here we go. So, now you can see it better. Now, it said days, and then it said Monday. So, there you go. You can see exactly what the days and hours and stuff. So I'm gonna keep moving down in that column by Ctrl+Alt+down arrow.
Row 3 Tuesdays.
And you notice it reads all of the days in a row. So if you're looking for a certain day, you can use this command or whatever, you know, for the hours. But let's say I want to move over a column. So you can do that by Ctrl+Alt+right arrow.
Column 2 730.m to 2.m.
All right. Those are, now we're in the hours column. So, you moved from one to another by doing Ctrl+Alt+left or right arrow. So, left arrow will move you back. So, let's do that here.
Column 1 Tuesday.
See, it moves you to the previous and next columns. And then Ctrl+Up arrow moves you up. So,
row 2 Mondays.
It moves you up in the table. So, another thing we're going to demonstrate is, I don't know if there's another table on here, so let's figure out.
Table with 11 rows and 2 columns, row 1, column 1, date.
There is, okay.
No next table.
No next table. Okay, so this is when you've reached where there's no more tables on the page. NVDA will say no next table. So you just keep heading T, and it should bring you, and it says no next table. Because if you're looking for something specific, you know, maybe it's not in that table or whatever. So that's kind of a good way to see how that works. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. This was a quick video. Please subscribe because I'm going to have some more videos coming out and it's going to be pretty awesome. The live library demos were pretty good too because they help you learn how to use the library system search. So if you have any questions, please comment down below and I hope to see you guys next time.
TechSmith's button.